Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of Our World. In today's video, we're gonna talk about compound bows. So before talking about compound bows, let's talk about archery. So archery is a Latin word. It's derived from Latin language and it's centuries old sport. There are four different types of bows: recurve bow, cross bow, long bow and compound bow. So today we are talking about this compound bow. It's a threadbare compound bow. The draw length on this bow is 29.5 inch. Draw weight is 80 pounds, but draw weight is changeable. It starts from 60 pounds and goes up to like 90-120 pounds. I'm using apex sight on it. It has 4 pins in it, so it's a 4-pin apex sight. This bow has 2 cams. These are called the cams or pulleys. For voice reduction, I have these 2 flies on this string. This is the kisser that you put on near your lip during shooting, and this is called peep sight. This is the grip and this is bow stabilizer. These are called the bow limbs. So this is all about this compound bow. Now let's talk about the arrows. So basically there are 3 types of arrows: wooden arrows, carbon fiber arrows and aluminium arrows. Aluminium arrows are the heaviest one. I have this over here. So basically these arrows make more impact than carbon fiber arrows, but they are slow because they are heavy. Then I have this carbon fiber arrow and it has field tip on it. So these field tips are used for sports shooting and target shooting. They are not used for hunting. For hunting we use broadheads, and broadheads look like this. This is a broadhead and these blades are razor sharp, so make sure when are you like dealing with broadheads, pay very careful attention because they can hurt you very bad. So this is one type of broadhead I have, and I'll show you guys another type of broadhead I use. That's this one. So basically the difference is, as you can see, that the tip on this broadhead looks like field tip. So the accuracy again increases if you have aerodynamics. In that broadhead, the aerodynamics is little bit out. So that's why these arrowheads work little bit better in accuracy. What happens basically, once you shoot this arrow, it goes like a field tip. Once it hits an animal, these razors blades just open like that and make a lot of damage and help to dispatch that animal fast and easy in a more respectful way. So this is my quiver I used on my compound bow. I can keep 4 arrows in it. Then let's talk about this release. This is a release. It goes on your hand like this and you tie it up. Then this is the trigger on your release. You use it for shooting your bow. This is your forearm guard. So especially for beginners, I would recommend it that they use it, because sometimes when you are not holding your bow properly or like it slipped out, it can hurt your forearm very badly and leave like a very bad scar on your forearm. So use this. Then for in archery, it's very important to know your distance where you are shooting. For that, I use this Bushnell rangefinder. So it's pretty good, compact, and I also use it for my rifle shooting. So probably in future videos I will show you guys my rifles and my range when I'll go to range for shooting my guns. And this is the binoculars. They are outbound. I'm using them. They are like little bit big, but they work. And let me tell you that it's very important to know your surrounding when you are taking a shot. So make sure if you are shooting something that you know your target, you know what's beyond your target, and you know what's around your target. Be responsible shooter, guys. Don't take irresponsible shots because you can hurt somebody very badly. So yeah, that's pretty much everything about compound bows that I can give you guys in a short amount of time. And in future videos I will discuss everything in more detail. And please make sure to subscribe my channel, because a lot of good content is about to come. And as you guys know that I give like informative context in my videos, so you will learn something new every day. And this is a good knife, so basically if you are getting into hunting, I would suggest to have a good knife with you, especially if you are in the bush or somewhere. So yeah, that's pretty much everything that you need to get into the sports. And yeah, about the prices, so this bow specifically cost like around $900 to $1,000, somewhere around that range. And there are some cheaper bows too, you can check the price online, and it's not that expensive. This is basically like a upper level or professional bow, but you can start with. And especially I will recommend you, if you are new to archery or if you are getting into archery, start with like 40 pound draw weight to 50 pound draw weight. Don't just go to 80 pound or 70 pounds, because that can hurt your back very badly. You have to build those muscles in your back, muscles memory, in order to pull that string. It's like 80 pounds, but when you are pulling it on a bow, you have to keep it steady. I'll show you guys, like I'll take some shots after, later in this video, I'll show you guys that how I take my shots and how I pull it. But yeah, so make sure to subscribe my channel, and I have Instagram too. It's rworld110, so you guys can send me message or follow me there, or I'll follow you guys back. And yeah, we will be in touch, and just let me know how you find this video, and please like this video, comment, subscribe. I'm taking a shot from 20 yards. That's the ideal distance to shoot, like if you are hunting with bows. So I'm shooting from 20 yards, but just make sure if you are sighting in your bow, so sight in your bow like from 10 yards. And if you're shooting it, then you can shoot it from 70 yards or 100 yards, it doesn't matter. But yeah, so I'll try to show you guys how to hold it when you are shooting it. So this is the release, it goes on the string. Then as I mentioned earlier, that you don't have to grip it really hard, just grip it lightly. Then deep breath, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, and then exhale, and then stop and take a shot. Thanks for watching the video. Our world, respect, explore, and enjoy together. Thanks. Peace.